Okay, so welcome back. Today we are going to learn chapter 3, transportation. This is a form 3 syllabus. So today we are going to learn about the section of the plant. I think we all learned this before. I don't know whether, I think not, we haven't learned this right during standard 6, where the plant, if I take the leaf, I cut the leaf, it will be something like this. Clear not if I cut the leaf. And if I want to take the stem, I cut here, I will have something like this. And if I cut here, I got something like this. Very easy to remember. We only need to remember the center part, 中间. The center part is called xylem. The center bit, more center towards, you can see from here, xylem, and xylem. Usually the exam question, they won't ask you to draw, they will give you like a picture, please label it. So the inner part will be the xylem. Except for here, we can see that this one is up, down, but seldom ask lah in the cross section of the leaf. Usually ask in the cross section of the stem. Okay, the center part is the xylem, phloem. You see the xylem, the color blue. Why is it color blue? Blue color. So we can see that it's blue color because it's water mah. Water, you put blue color lah. So we can see here the function of xylem, water and mineral are adsorbed. Usually xylem, the function of xylem is to transport water and dissolved mineral salt. Phloem is to transport sucrose during photosynthesis. So one is, as I remember last time we got learned like xylem to transport water, phloem is to transport food. But now we are already form 3. We want to remember xylem not only transport water, but it also transport the mineral salt. Phloem to transport food, but if you put food in your exam paper, you won't get any mark. You need to say transport sucrose, like sucrose lah, glucose, sucrose. Okay, let's look at this. So this one you need to know, just remember lah, okay? Transport water and dissolved mineral salt. Another one is to transport sucrose. It's the food lah actually. But if you put food, you don't get any mark. Okay, so again, made of transport and we found in the vascular bundle. So the leaf one is like that, vascular bundle, and the stem. So what is the stem, what is the leaf lah, okay? Actually, it's still the same part, which is the inner part actually carry the water. Visit the following website to carry the structure. Okay, no need. Okay, so now we want to do experiment to study the direction of water in a plant. So what is happening at here is he put red color coloring. Why you want to put color, red color, eosin coloring? Because after a while, if you want to cut the cross section of the plant, we'll find the middle section is the red color. Rather than blue is water, right? I mean, blue is not water, but red, we can see the red color in the plant. Eventually, we also will see the leaf a bit of reddish or the flower is a bit reddish. So let's look at this. After 30 minutes, make a cross section of the leaf stem. After you cut the knife, the cross section, examine it. So actually, after you cut it, here the xylem part will be red, the xylem part here will be red, and the xylem part in the leaf will be red. And maybe the leaf also will be slightly red a bit. Examine the cross-sectional microscope, draw a label diagram, each section that has been observed, identify the label. So you need to draw this one. Okay, let's look at the question. Question 1. Is the eosin solution spread evenly or does it have specific pattern in the leaf, stem, and root of the plant? So the answer will be The ocean solutions tend to form a pattern. Okay, there's a pattern. How does the pattern look like? The pattern will be like this lah. Like it's spread all red or certain place red. Here only red. This part is only red. This part only. This part is red. Because it's xylem, telenutrient. Here will be red. And the upper part will be the red. You cannot. You get what I mean? So there's a pattern showing that xylem only carry dissolved mineral salt and water. If everywhere means the plant use every part to carry the water, but only the specific part, which is the xylem that carry the water, which is the red color part. And then no, because it's red color. How you know? Because red color. Before this, you cut no color. Let's look at the question number 2. Name the part of the color red in the cross section: root, leaf, root, stem. In this activity, name the part. So what is the name of the red color part? So the answer will be xylem. Xylem is only the center part. Correct or not? Here center ma. So xylem is the part lah. So here will be red, red. He asks you what part ma? Xylem. It means xylem will become red color. And the last question, what is the conclusion of this activity? So, correct. Passage of water travel in a part called xylem. Correct, not only the xylem part that is red color, showing that that part transport mineral salt and it transport dissolved mineral salt and water. I hope you can understand. Studying the direction of the plant. Now we already do some experiment about xylem. We know xylem can transfer water. It's red color. After we do the experiment, we okay. It's red color. It's xylem. How about phloem? Because we already test xylem. Correct or not? We already test xylem. How to test phloem? Because I cannot use red color. Red color how? Red color. So we can test phloem by doing like this. I cut out the outer part of the branch or the stem, the bud. I cut out and I see what will happen. Then I need to draw. If I want to draw this, so if I want to draw this, it'll be something like this. The part is swollen and become fat. Why become fat? Because up here is the leaf, correct? No. Up the tree is the leaf. The leaf will do photosynthesis to make food. And the food need to go down. Now you cut the phloem. We already know that phloem is to carry the nutrient. So it cannot go down. So here will become very fat. Notice that only up fat lah, down here no fat. Because the food is from up to down and the water is from down to up. Can? Cannot. So now by doing the experiment, we know that the food is from up to down, the water is from down to up. But how to do the water from down to up? Maybe we can use photometer. Correct or not? We already study, just put some water, the water get less, more water go up. So I prove water from the root to the leaf, and the food is from the leaf to the root. It's because this part up here become very fat. Let's erase this so that it won't be messy. Oops, accidentally redid. So what is the conclusion of this activity? Okay, so the answer will be passage of food in the plant travel to phloem. Correct or not? Because the food stuck up there, so it cannot go down. So we know that the food travel to the phloem because we already cut the phloem already, throw away the phloem. So the food cannot go down, stuck at there. Very easy. Okay. Okay, so for this exercise for Mathematics 3.4, I think this the answer is in the book, so you can do the revision by yourself. After you finish chapter, I will do some video about doing some exercise. Blood circulatory system in animal and plant. Correct or not? Because we already know for tree we have the water as their blood. For us, we got the blood, also got water, ma. But only the water is the blood. So let's look at this question. Studies show blood circulation in animal and transplant the plant have made us aware the uniqueness and the circulatory system and the continuum of life organism created by God. Wow, here got the word God. If this is America and not America, I don't know lah, some other country they will take out the word God. What are the similar difference between the blood of animal and plant? So, blood circulation we really learn, right? In human, we got the heart, we got capillary, artery, and vein. And we got artery and capillary. For the plant, the only difference is it got no pump. Human got pump. The pump is the heart. Plant only plant. You just need the sun. The sun will cause transpiration and the thing will go up. Vessel, artery, capillary, vein. For plant got xylem and phloem. We got carry oxygenated blood, deoxygenated blood, but for plant is xylem or phloem. But actually, human is more complex lah. Not only we got carry, we carry oxygen, we carry a lot of other things, mineral salt and other things. In terms of transport vessel, artery and capillary and vein, same thing to transport the nutrient and everything. This one is xylem and phloem are not connected. Artery, capillary and vein, at the end of the day, it will connect, correct or not? From the artery, it will go to your vein, oxygen use, then it will cycle, turn. But for plant, xylem is xylem, phloem is phloem. Carry water means you carry water and mineral salt. Carry the sucrose means you just carry the sucrose. So there is no mixing of the two things. So 3.5 again. This one you can find your answer in your textbook. So I recommend you pause it and do by yourself. And then I will go to the next question. Yes, when you finish this one and summative practice also, I think you got the answer in the book. So we are going to do some exercise from other book. Correct? I don't want to waste your time, right? You can do by yourself. Or if you need me to do to explain you, let me know so I will do a video for the question. Okay, so let's do some practice. This is practice from a book that I found. Let's do some practice. The diagram below show a few type of organism marked correct on the organism that do not need transport system. Lynch thing.
They can get sufficient oxygen and nutrients from the environment through diffusion.
Correct also. Wait lah. Not like that one. Correct. Why my computer like that one? Oh, Okay, let's type in the, put in the answer. Maybe I can say, in simple organism, materials move in and out of the cell directly by diffusion. Hence, in a simple organism, material moves in out of the cell directly by diffusion. Hence, this organism do not need a transport system. Limiting.
Correct.
I mean, yeah. So what is the answer? Which one is correct?
First one is correct.
Second one? Second one?
Wrong.
The second one is wrong. How about C?
All right.
D?
Wrong.
D wrong. Let's see. Why is it considered as simple or complex? So basically, we want to consider it as simple because we are talking about diffusion. Here also diffuse. So it's simple because diffusion is like you put the thing and then it will just diffuse. Complex, it will be not diffusion, but either by respiration and so on. But one thing you notice is if diffusion, it will be simple because it's just like the aquarium, like I put water, the oxygen go into water, so they consider diffusion as a simple process. Next, complete the multi-flow map below to show the consequence of non-functional transport system. Non-functional transport system. So failure of heart, yeah, like heart attack, blood vessel burst is stroke. So the first one is talking about heart attack or heart failure. The second one is talking about stroke and non-function. But why this thing happen? Why? I mean, this question is a bit difficult because it don't, it's not clear the question actually, but you can say roughly the answers like this, okay? Non-functional transport system. Why? Okay, because you got a heart failure and you got stroke, bao hei kun. So, what is non-functional? The blood cannot flow. No blood, lor. But what no blood means, the blood cannot move, then they die, lah, because there's no oxygen. Right now. So, if the blood cannot flow, there's no oxygen to the brain. And how many minutes? 3 minutes. I forgot. 2 or 3 minutes. Your oxygen without going to the brain, you will die. That's why if you let them there, you see the movie, you 2-3 minutes no oxygen, the brain cells start to die. Means the person will die. The substance cannot transport, cannot be transported. Okay. We don't want to talk about nutrient now. We want to talk about oxygen especially. Since there's no oxygen to the brain in like 3 minutes. Then the person, the brain cell start to die. When your brain cell die, means the person die lah. So I think it will be like the heart stop first, then you help me, help me, help me. But the brain start not to get oxygen, then you're like help me. Then the person will die due to heart attack or stroke. Stroke die even worse. It's like. Then the person die. I think stroke is even worse. Hopefully, when I die, when I'm old, I want to die peacefully. I don't want to die like the Korean drama. I want to sleep on the bed and then sleep and die. But I read the statistics say that usually when we die, by statistic lah, there is certain pain. Not a very, very a lot of pain, but there is a certain pain. So, all must die, lor. The human blood circulatory system consists of the heart, the blood. Okay, let's look at this question. Let's look at this question and see what this question want. Okay, name the component. Very easy. Component. What are these three components? Very easy. Of course, this one you know. This is heart. And this like the water one is blood. No, people say iron matter, right? Like crying blood. And this one will be the blood vessel. Number two, vertebrate animal. What is vertebrate animal? Are you a vertebrate animal? I mean, in science, you are a vertebrate animal. Like, because you got backbone, right? So in science, we are considered as vertebrate animal. Like, I'm always wondering why you want to call human animal. Has different blood circulation system. Yeah. Complete the diagram below to differentiate the circulatory system between mammal, amphibian, fish, and bird. So this is the part that I scared the most because a lot of things you need to memorize. Okay, so this will be the answer, okay, for the group of mammal, amphibian, fish, and bird. This one you just need to memorize, okay? For mammal, it's double close complete. For amphibian, it's double close incomplete, single close complete, double close complete. Atrium is two, correct or not? We got left atrium and right atrium. Two, two, one, two. And ventricle, we also got two ventricle, left ventricle and right ventricle. Two, one, two, two. Two, one, one, two. So yeah, I think you just need to memorize this, okay? Yeah. If you know how to draw, I think it's easier. Like, if you want to memorize this, I recommend that you draw it. Draw it, label it, and you will know. Because if you draw, usually you remember what you draw. When is the last time you draw Mickey Mouse? I think you can remember, right? When the last time you... I mean, at least you know what you are drawing. Draw it out so it's easier for you to remember. If you want to memorize, use your imagination. Just imagine your brain. Blah, 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 blah. Number three, let's look at question number three. Okay, so I think we do and finish until here, and I continue the class next time. And I see you next time. Hope that you enjoy it. Thank you, and bye bye.